As we have discussed many times here on TYT Sports, we absolutely love the bickering that Charles Barkley and Shaquille O'Neal have on Inside the NBA. We've also discussed many times, as Jayar Jackson and Robert Littal are here, that it seems like they respect one another but still have a lot of airing out to do. This is probably like chapter 7, but they still need to continue doing it. So here was the latest escapade and the journey that they took us on as viewers between Shaq and Charles.
You know, I'm just glad that you guys come to some type of understanding.
We never had a misunderstanding. That's what you don't understand.
First of all, you stop lying.
First of all, you see this right here? I built this. This was my locker room. There was never, ever a misunderstanding. You just thought it was a misunderstanding because you like gossip. Yeah. Don't listen to gossip. Yeah. We won 3 out of 4. We didn't have a disagreement. We had two competitive guys, alpha males. We don't have beef. We won 3 out of 4 championships, and that's the only thing you need to remember.
You guys probably should have won more.
I got traded. You know, we went to the finals in 2004, 2005, and I got traded.
Yeah, but if y'all has been able to sit down and talk, y'all would have won.
It was never, but see, first of all, Chuck, you don't know what you're talking about. We ain't never had beef. That's what you
I know. You
that's what the interview
that,
is about.
Okay, I'm sorry I didn't preface it. It's obviously between Shaq and Kobe Bryant. Ooh. Now,
the discussion topic, yes.
Yeah, before I get to the boys here. Him saying that there was no disdain at all for one another. Fox Sports report, things got so bad, Shaq wanted to murder Kobe Bryant.
Murder.
Especially us, the young brothers, we always worry about useless titles, O'Neal told the LA Times. Like, I'm the man, it's my team, stuff that doesn't matter anyway. And I think there was a little bit too much focus on that by both of us. However, we were able to overcome that and still find a way to dominate and play together. However, what hurt LA? Young egos, Kobe and Shaq, said former Lakers guard Ron Harper. I love them both, but see, I respect Kobe because Kobe came to training camp in shape, ready to rock and roll. Shaq had to play himself into game shape. But if they could have just found a way to coexist a little damn bit, just a little bit, they could have won 5 championships on the same team. They were 1A and 1A. That's what created all the anxiety, said Rick Fox. What neither one of them realized is the effect that it had on the rest of us, said Brian Shaw. And then there was more so of it. Phil Jackson said, no more public sparring or you'll get fined. I appreciate Shaquille O'Neal sticking up for what occurred from a historical context, or rather not sticking up and just trying to rewrite the woes. However, it's already written, so
well,
just call a spade a spade.
Wrote it too when he was in that, it was a bar or a club, and he went up on stage and said, Kobe, tell me how my ass tastes.
Tell me how my ass tastes.
Had a whole song, freestyled a verse or two.
Right, last time I checked, Kobe couldn't win without me.
Yeah. He just won with Miami, right? No, Kobe had just lost with Powell.
Right.
So they documented it themselves. On TNT, they were promoting their one-on-one discussion. I saw that and I was like, oh, I actually want to see this one. Because sometimes those things I want to sit down and watch, but I have to get myself settled in because I get up all the time. I have a kid and I'm jumping. I was like, I want to sit down and watch this uninterrupted. Just off of that one piece. Because they brought up how Shaq came in out of shape every year. And then they were having a calm, quiet conversation, and that got both of them animated. Because Shaq admitted, he goes, I knew I had a guy who was relentless and you who was an assassin, and I could come in out of shape. And Kobe jumped on him. He goes, that's what I hated about you. And I was like, that's it. He could have pissed me off. I was like, okay, I like it. I want to see this.
I'll take a little different angle with this.
Please.
Because I thought about this when you told me this was going to be the topic. I want to address this to all the people they have beef with Kevin Durant.
Oh.
Yeah, beef with Kevin Durant.
Oh.
Say Kevin Durant cherry picked a title. Cherry picked a championship. You know why Kevin Durant did that? Because he didn't one day in 10 years want to be sitting on a set trying to just talk to somebody regular about something they said and then have somebody look at him and say, how many rings you got? How many rings you got is like your girl saying, I just find it funny. It's the end of any type of conversation. So anything, like Charles was very relaxed, was just trying to talk about the segment, something that Shaq physically and actually said to Kobe. It's on tape. It's okay. Kobe, I'm pissed off. I can't believe you did that. They actually are talking about it. And know what Charles said? I mean, know what Shaq said? You don't know how many championships. Google me. That's why these guys go team up.
Mm-hmm.
Because you do not want to be that guy with no rings.
So you're saying in 20 years, we're not going to have the narrative of somebody saying, he ring chased.
Nope, not at all. Not at all.
Early enough. You only get ring chasing when you're late.
They don't even talk about LeBron in Miami no more. You know, I went back, got another one. Like,
yeah. I tend to disagree.
I think they still do.
Because it started the downhill effect. What changed all of it was just winning in Cleveland.
Right.
That's what changed the entire narrative.
So the thing is, the narrative changes as you go along.
Completely.
Right?
Yes.
Think about how people really argued about Kobe when Kobe was playing, right after Shaq left. And all the things that they said in his case and all this stuff. Then he wins a couple and how they change. And now.
Well, hang on one second. Just pause it for a second. The narrative was when he won with Powell was, oh, he needed Powell to win. Right?
Yeah. So now when people talk about Kobe now, Kobe Bryant today, you don't hear a lot of negative.
No.
Kobe's doing an Oscar. Yeah, he got it. That's great. Oh, Kobe. Kobe's going to talk. Kobe's going to talk to Shaq. Yeah. Everything's Kobe. Kobe got a statue. Kobe got two. Everybody loves Kobe.
Mm-hmm. Basketball.
My prime, my life is paralleled with Kobe's life. Like, we're around the same age. I know what people were saying about Kobe throughout his entire career, from the time he came from the time he took brandy to this prom and dropped his girl, high school girlfriend. I knew what people were saying about Kobe to Kobe now, this 21 year time frame. Uh-huh. It changes as you get older.
Right.
When LeBron is retired, watch it. Watch how it changes. He's going to be seen really, really high once everybody sits back and realizes everything. It's hard to do it in the moment. Right. And so for someone like Kevin Durant or Chris Paul trying to do it now or whoever, 20 years from now, when they're replaying things, they're going to replay Kevin Durant shooting a shot over LeBron James. And people will be like, hey, that guy was good.
Yeah.
Because the old people are, you know, we're old. New kids, they don't know. Don't you ask a 20-year-old about Kobe, they just, that's Kobe. They don't know all of the backstory. So that's why age does that. So I think in the back of some players' minds, they don't want to be.
They don't want to be Charles against Shaq.
And the players that fraternity will always remember, no matter how old, how retired they are. I mean, every time Karl Malone shows up, which he doesn't much, they clown him.
Yeah. Totally.
You don't want to be that guy. You don't want to be the guy that doesn't win.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, if you're the Falcons right now, you are right there. He lost.
Right.
The Eagles, that first one, and forever. All of those guys on the Eagles will never have to do anything again. That's the difference between winning and losing in the championship. Mm-hmm. The difference is everybody's going to say, you're a champion. X time. They don't start off with all-star MVPs or MVP. Yeah. You know what they start off? X time champion.
Yep.
NBA champion.
Yeah.
Then it's Hall of Famer, blah, 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 blah.
All right, so let me ask you both something. There is a rumor, and it's going to be linked until it's dispelled, but LeBron James is entering free agency. If he teamed up with Golden State, are we not going to remember that one? Or are we just going to say, he might have joined a great team, but he still won his fourth and his fifth? Because I have to think he'd probably win
two. You mean 20 years down the road?
Sure, yeah.
It's a footnote. It's a footnote.
Considering his caliber of player.
I don't know, man. I tend
just because the caliber of player.
Now, that's pushing it. But then again, if he lost three more finals in the East,
absolutely.
What would you rather be remembered for?
Of course.
What I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm just saying, if he were to hypothetically join Golden State, I think the narrative would change. I really do.
I think,
because he's the best player. It's just a little bit different than Kevin Durant.
He would do what Kevin Durant did after Kevin Durant did it. Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
It would be a narrative. Just like you can't 100% get away from it. Like, Kobe can't 100% get away from some things that have happened in his past. Uh-huh. But it's just how far down the thing that you get, you know, to it. And I think people don't think about it like that. So you say, oh, well, Kevin Durant did all of this stuff. What if Kevin Durant went back to Oklahoma City and they lost? You know what they would call him? A loser. that can't win the big one. That can't win the championship. Mm-hmm. So I would rather be hated with the ring.
And he literally shows up the most hated school in college football.
Hated with the ring. Zoom in on that. There you go. Zoom in. You see that? That's a championship ring from the Ohio State University. I didn't play, but when people see the ring, they say you went to Ohio State. Oh, you're a champion. See, that's what I'm saying. If you went to Vanderbilt, nobody would care about your Vanderbilt ring. Nobody says, hey, here's my Purdue ring. Oh, Purdue.
Screw Purdue.
Nobody says that.
Screw their engineering school.
The valet guy out there say, hey, Mr. Ohio State, you're back. You know why? Because he respects it.
And he remembers it.
He remembers it.
That's right.
If I went to Purdue, he would say, who are you? And it costs $5 to park. But I go to Ohio State, the man gives me a bottled water. He gives me directions. We talk for 5 minutes before I come in. You know why? Because he respects the ring.
Still holding it.
He respects the ring. He wouldn't do that for you. He wouldn't do that for you if you went to Georgia Tech. There's no respect for you. What's a yellow jacket anyway? Is that a B? Nobody cares about that. Championships, rings matter. Robert Littal. Hey, clap it. Yeah, clap it.
I like it. I like it. As much as I dislike Ohio State.
I go off on these tangents. I got a lot of anger.
Clearly.
A lot of anger.
The only thing I disagree with you is the most hated is more like Alabama than Ohio State.
Yeah. No, I don't.
You think so?
I don't.
They're up there.
Ohio State's been good in both sports, both major sports. Thus, the more hate.
You think more hate?
Definitely. Thoughts, comment section, subscribe to 2IT Sports.